Welcome back. Let's continue on to episode 3.
There's an isolated community in the northern part of Great Bear. Someone there is very sick.
Great Bear? There's nothing there anymore. Not since...
I know. But I have to get there.
I seem to recall a town somewhere up north, far, what was it called? That's it. Perseverance Mills.
It was like sparks everywhere and then fire. She fought like hell to try and get him out. We tried to stop her, but she ended up on the bus. Somehow, she was small enough to crawl through the crushed part.
Did you see the lights in the night sky? The aurora? Well, when that flared up, the radio came to life. Just lit up. Started spitting out noise, but it was all gibberish.
Hello? Is this the radio station at Perseverance Mills? Is there a doctor with you?
And we encountered this asshole.
What's in the case?
I have no idea.
Don't worry, pilot. You'll be with her soon.
Mm-hmm. And we go through the intro again. It is now episode 3. Can I skip it? No. Oh, I want to skip the intro. I've seen it before. It's fairly recent if you've been watching this daily. Are we still going to be playing Mackenzie is the question. Because this is the final episode that we have access to, and there's still two more afterwards that aren't released yet. So once we finish all this, we're going to stop recording, and I think I'll come back to it when episodes 4 and 5 are actually fully out. The Long Dark. Because this game's been out since 2014, so it is coming up to 7 years old. Right? Yeah. So it's at least 6 years old. And there's 3 episodes, so... It's a different gun. So we're going to be playing the wife now. Or the ex-wife, sorry.
So, she lives.
Where am I?
And she speaks. You're in my house. Found you out in the snow a few days ago.
A few days?
Almost dead. You're half frozen and then feverish. Judging by those cuts, you've been dealing with more than just the bad weather.
I ran into some trouble on the other side of that tunnel.
By the looks of it, I'd say the trouble ran into you.
Where am I?
I told you. My house. You're still weak. Rest up and we'll talk more later.
No. I'll be okay.
Suit yourself. Then let's talk.
You said we're in your house. But how did I get here?
I was out hunting. Came across you in the snow. Buried. You'd been out there for hours. Maybe even days. Nearly dead.
Wow. Well, thank you. Finding me.
Name's Molly. And don't thank me. Thank the crow.
Crow?
Yeah, crow. Or maybe a raven. Damn bird wouldn't shut up. Led me straight to you. Almost like it was guiding me.
You carried me here?
Dragmore-like, but yeah. You're pretty far gone. Wasn't sure you'd make it, to be honest.
Well, all I remember is the tunnel. And the wolves. Being chased, and then wandering. Forever. Like the world had no end.
Yeah. In the woods. In the dark. You can wander for days until you get so hopelessly lost. There's just no way to get back to where you were.
I was in a small town. Milton.
Other side of the mountains. Old town. Bad shape since the collapse. Haven't been there in ages. You must have wandered a ways for me to find you where I did. But you're not from there.
No. The old town. Milton. Most of them are. It was fire and...
Whoa, it's okay. You're all right now. Don't get too worked up. You nearly died out there. That does funny things to people.
Is this your kitchen?
By the time I got you here, there was no way I was carrying you upstairs.
So you set up a bed in here?
Hours out. This is the warmest room in the house. This cook stove is probably keeping us alive.
So, power's been out for a while?
Yep.
Think it'll come back?
Nope.
Well, we're used to the power going on and off out here in Pleasant Valley, so we're usually prepared for it. Feels like you run this farm on generators for the better part of the year. Problem is, now the generators won't start. Or the cars, tractor, the TV's dead, radio won't work. Basically, the only thing that works is the old landline and rotary phone.
How is that possible?
I guess because it's pre-electronics. The old party line from when this farm was originally put in, maybe 60, 70 years ago. I'm not exactly sure how or why it still works, but it does.
Well, that's great. Can you call for help? Find out what's going on out there?
There's nobody to call.
Nobody else lives around here?
Nobody who'd help if you asked for it.
I was in a plane crash in the mountains. That's how I ended up in Milton. I got separated from a friend.
They were in the crash too?
Yes.
They make it out alive?
Well, there was a storm. Wolves. I got disoriented. We got separated. I couldn't see him.
Him? So you left him out there?
And then I ran into trouble. Wolves and worse. I'm sure he made it out fine.
Yeah? How are you so sure?
Nothing could break that stubborn skull.
But you're worried about him.
Yes. And there's something I need from the plane.
What is it?
Something important. I need to find him. I need to get it back. You haven't seen a man pass through here.
Nobody that sounds like your guy.
But you've seen a man.
Like I said, nobody that sounds like your guy. Freezer's empty. You're gonna need energy to heal, which means we need meat. I'll be heading out early to hunt.
Okay.
You should stay here. Rest up some more. You don't look too good.
Thank you. I will.
And it's not safe out there, so just stay in the house.
Right.
I mean it. Stay in the house. Ah, you're awake. Thought you were resting. Managed to bag a stag not far from the farm. This'll keep us fed for a bit.
I heard a kettle whistling.
I put it on for tea. So we can have tea and meat.
I must be starting to feel better because that actually sounds good.
It's amazing what hunger does to the mind. If you're feeling better, you can start answering some questions. Like, what the hell are you really doing out here?
That's a long story.
Well, power's been out for, I've lost track of how long. We got the cold, we got deadly blizzards, we got hungry wolves, we got some tea and meat. We aren't going anywhere. So to be honest, a bit of storytelling be a nice distraction right about now.
I'm a doctor. Dr. Astrid Greenwood.
Nice to meet you, Dr. Astrid. Like a head colds and babies doctor?
More like lab coats and test tubes. A researcher.
Okay, so not the useful kind.
I need to get to a town up north. Perseverance Mills. You know where that is?
I don't get out much, but yeah, I've heard of it.
Okay. Well, there's some sick people there, and they need my help. And the thing I lost in the plane crash. The thing my friend might have. I need it if I'm gonna help those people.
The thing the stubborn guy you left in the plane crash might have?
Right.
So what you're saying is the thing you need is on the other side of that collapsed tunnel in the mountains? In the place where you ran into trouble?
That's right.
You know what? You coming here, The Great Bear?
Yeah.
Not your best plan. So the people up north, in Perseverance Mills, why are they sick?
I'm not entirely sure. That's why I need to get there.
You must have some ideas, or why travel all this way?
I have some ideas, yes.
But you aren't going to tell me what they are.
No, I'm not.
And the thing your friend in the plane crash has, the thing you need to help them? You aren't going to tell me what it is either, are you?
Right.
Well, you are a lady with a lot of secrets.
So, when you came in, I heard you locking a padlock. Same thing when you went out. Am I locked in here?
It's better for you to stay indoors.
Why?
Lots of wolves out there, and it's cold. You aren't strong enough to go out there yet. Trust me, it's for your own safety.
I appreciate everything you've done to help. But I'd like to leave. I have to find my friend and get on with my work.
When you're stronger.
So, I'm trapped in here.
Like I said, it's for your own good.
So, is your husband around?
Husband?
It seems like more than one adult lives here. I assumed, husband.
Assumptions can be dangerous. You're a doctor, you should know that.
I didn't mean to...
You should just mind your own business.
But you just got back.
I need space. Need to think.
I'm sorry.
Stay out of my shit.
Looks like I'm not the only one with secrets.
No, we're not staying out of your shit, lady. Where's the phone?
hell took you so long?
Hello?
Thank God you answered.
Molly?
Yeah, it's me. Listen up, doctor.
Okay.
They have me surrounded. They're smart sons of bitches.
Who has you surrounded? Are you in trouble?
Not who. What? It's those damn wolves. They've cornered me in the barn. Sounds like they're trying to find a way in.
But wolves don't usually bother people.
Don't bother people. Shit, lady, haven't you been paying attention? Never mind that.
Okay, what can I do?
I need you to bring me something from the house.
Okay, but you locked me in here, remember?
Flower vase. Key to the basement's under it. Look for the gun locker. Grab the rifle rounds. Take the old revolver for protection. Might not stop a wolf, but it'll slow one down. Follow the blizzard line from the house to the barn. Get here quick and we'll figure it out. Hurry!
Okay, I'm on my way.
Go straight to the gun locker. Stay out of everything else, got it?
Phase.
Got it.
Stay out of everything else, all right? And the husband. Okay. All right. The wolves.
There are the lines to the barn.
Cool. Just means you can't move. Gotcha. Oh. Okay.
Hello?
That you?
Molly?
Yeah. Look, sorry I bailed on you, but I couldn't take a chance and wait. One of those big bastards broke into the barn. And as luck would have it, I'd left my bow in here last summer, completely forgot. Anyways, took care of that son of a bitch.
Molly, I was in your basement.
Right. So?
I found the body. Molly, who was it?
It's none of your business. I told you to stay out of my shit.
An old flyer for a town meeting of some kind. Looks like the town's not too far from here. If Mackenzie did pass through, he might have ended up there.
Okay. So many goddamn wolves. Okay. Well. I will end the episode here, so I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, subscribe and smash the notification bell to keep up to date. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!